So what you need a person table. Person tables helps us to take to make decision. What kind of decision? At the time of generating power streams, how to choose a production route? So right. So still now, what was happening when we was trying to generate a part stream? We were choosing the production rule by some kind of guess and intuition and kind of, you know, our perception on the problem we was doing. But right now, we will develop a parsing table, a parse table, which will help us to take the decision better. And we will have less number of backtracking and mistakes. So how to construct this parse table? For each production, A to alpha of a grammar G, what you will do? For each terminal A in first alpha, add A alpha to match AB. So first, let me show you roughly how this table will look like. The table will look like this, okay? All the terminal symbols will be written in the top or header. So here in our case, our terminal symbols was like ID, we had plus, we had multiplication sign, opening bracket, closing bracket, right? All these things was there. And what are the variable or non-terminal was there? We had E dash, we had E, we had T and so on. So when you are saying that match E comma E, here you can understand this capital A means a non-terminal, and this A means a terminal. Now, what we have to fill up this box, okay, this table. Now, if you think about this cell of the table, it is basically M, E dash, comma, ID. Okay? So, for each terminal A in first alpha, add A to alpha to M A dash. Okay, so all first of the body, alpha is here the body, right? This alpha is the body of, this is body of rule. Okay, so all first alpha we have already calculated. Now if epsilon in first alpha, then add terminal A in follow A, add A to alpha to match A to E. So what it is saying that if sometimes we get this, you know, like we had a production rule like E dash to epsilon. So if you find some production rule is like this, then what you will do? You will add this production rule to follow up E positions, so follow up E dash here, right? So follow up E dash positions, okay? If epsilon is in first alpha, add dollar in follow A and add A to alpha to A comma dollar also, okay? So all other undefined entries in the parsing table are error entries. Like, you know, after doing the, after applying these three rules, we find it, you find that many positions in the table are remains empty or unfilled. So what about that? They are basically errors. Okay, so if we try to complete the table, then how it will look like? Okay, so let's move. This is our grammar. But this grammar, at the same time, so what we have to calculate first? First and follow. So first, we have to calculate for all the alpha and all the A's. That means first for all. Sorry. Body and non terminals. We have to calculate and follow for all the non terminals. So we have already calculated them, so I'm not calculating them again here. Okay. So this was our calculation, right? So, what is our next target? Our target is construction of the parse table. Okay, so let's try to generate the parse table here. So, what I had told you that we have to generate rows for each of the non-terminals. So, how many non-terminals we have? E dash, T, T dash, and F. So, 5, right? So, generate 5 rows here. Okay, put E, E dash, T, T dash, and F. And what are the non-terminals was there? It will see, sir, what are the terminals was there? If you see here, we had ID one terminal, ID, then we had plus, right? Then we had asterisk for multiplication, then we had opening bracket, we had closing bracket, you can see here, okay? Then we had a dollar here, right? So dollar also you have to treat as a non-terminal, as a terminal. Okay, so we have to create columns for each of them. Okay, ID plus multiplication, opening bracket, closing bracket, and dollar. Understand? So we have the table here. Next, what we have to do? We have to fill up the table with different rules. Okay? So let's try to do that. First one, if you see this table, this cell, here the match is basically E and ID. Okay, so what we will do, what rule we have studied just before few minutes in the previous slide, see, for each production rule A to alpha of the grammar rule, for each terminal A in first alpha, add A to alpha to all the matches. Okay, so what you have to see, first alpha. So here what is, we have E here, right? So we have to find out what are the things coming at the position of first alpha. So alpha is what? E to T E dash, right? So, we have the production rule E to T E dash. Okay, now this is our alpha, and this is our A, right? So from here, we have to find out, first alpha means T E dash, okay? Now find what is T E dash C. Here we have already calculated it, right? First T E dash, okay? What are the things are there? We have opening bracket and ID. So this rule will be entered at this position and at this position. What is the rule? E to T E dash, and here also E to T E dash. Done? Again, go for the next. Okay. Next, we just take another rule wise. Okay. So take this rule. We have A dash 2 plus T E dash. So what you have to see? What is the first of its body, right? So this is alpha, right? So first plus T A dash. What will be the answer? You can already see we have calculated plus, because plus is a non-nullable. So only plus will be in the first set, plus will come in. Okay. So this rule will be entered at this position. Okay, at this position. A dash 2 plus E dash. Done? Now, the next rule, if you see, this is something interesting. E dash to epsilon. So, what was the rule we had written there? You can see that if epsilon is first alpha, for each terminal A in hollow A, add A to alpha to the matches. Okay, so here epsilon is alpha. So first of epsilon will be epsilon. So if this is happening, then what we will do, we will search for follow up A. Here A is E dash. Follow up E dash we have already calculated. Here dollar and closing bracket. So in this position, so what are the position? M E dash dollar, this position, and M E dash dollar, this position, we have to fill up with this rule. Okay, so A dash dollar is here, so we will give here A dash to epsilon, and what is the other thing? Closing bracket, right? So here A dash to dollar, epsilon, right? So this is done. Okay. Next is, you see what rule is there? We have T2 F T dash. So what we have to do? We have to find out first alpha. So what is alpha? Alpha is F T dash. Okay. F is not nullable, right? So this equal to first of F. Okay, first of F we already calculated in previous day, opening bracket and dollar, opening bracket, and ID. okay, so where this rule is going to be enter at t comma opening bracket and at m t comma id. Okay, so t comma id we have to here have t to f t dash and at id done, then opening bracket here. Okay, t to f t dash. So this is also done. It is not nullable, so other thing we have not need to think about. Okay, done. Next is t dash. First rule is t dash to star f t dash. So again, first alpha will be only star. Okay, so this rule will be entered at t dash star at this position t dash to star f t dash. Okay, and there is another rule, that is t dash to epsilon. So first of epsilon will be epsilon. So we have to see what is follow of t dash, which we have already calculated here, plus closing bracket and dollar. Okay, so in these positions, what you have to enter t dash to epsilon, right? So plus you write t dash to epsilon, then at closing bracket t dash to epsilon, and at dollar you give t dash to epsilon. Okay, then this row is also down. Okay, so come to the last production rule, which is f to not last okay, after that another rule is there. We have f to in bracket e. So alpha is this one. First alpha is going to be only opening bracket, right? So in opening bracket at this position, we have to enter this rule f to in bracket e. Okay, another rule is there, that is f to id. So first alpha will be id only. So f comma id at this position, we have to enter this rule f to id. So we have our parse table. Okay, using this parse table, what will happen? We will easily able to take decision at the time of parsing a string or generating a parse tree for a given string based on this grammar. Understand? Okay, so this is the table they look like. So again, if you have any question up to this, you can ask me. If at any point you missed something, no questions, you can write in the chat box as you will if you have any question. Nothing. About that dollar sign, why we add that? Yes, good question. Yes, why we add that, right? See, what will happen if you put a dollar at the end of the start symbol of a grammar? What will happen? Whatever string we will, you know, whatever parse tree we will generate at the end, always you will get the dollar, right? Now, when we will, and after get, you know, completing the parse tree, when you will read the leaves, like ID somewhere plus, somewhere another ID, multiplication ID, when you will read the leaves, what will happen? Every time after the end of the leaf, you will get this leaf. So every time, you will have a terminating symbol at the end of your string. Understand? So this is the reason why we add this dollar. Because at the time of parsing, if you don't put a terminating symbol, your the reader, the symbol reader, will read continuous. It may continuously read the empty spaces. Like it happens when you read from array. If you have a very long array and you have put a string in the array whose size is 10 and your array size is 20, then what you do? We put a terminating symbol. Like if you put a string in the array, slash 0 is the terminating symbol automatically added, right? Like when you read input from file, there is the end of file symbol. So that you're going to, reader can understand, okay, this is the point where I have to end my reading. Understand? So here also, whenever we'll do parsing, parse algorithm we'll use, whenever we'll get this dollar sign, our parser will understand that, okay, this is the end of my parsing. Any other question? Rishabh, is it clear? If you still have some doubt regarding this dollar, next we are going to discuss some of the parsing technique using this table you have constructed. Okay, there it will be clear. Okay, so here something to note on this table, that is, you can see that this position, all these positions are empty position, right? So why and what does this signify? This signifies that if at the time of construction of your parse tree, you get to, you are searching for a match which does not have entry, like you are searching for a match e comma plus is this one, there is no entry, then what will happen? It will simply say error. That means what input string is given you to parse is not generatable or supported by this given grammar. Understand? Now LL1 grammar. So a grammar whose parsing table has no multiple entries inside is said to be LL1 grammar. So if you see here, there is no cell where is multiple entry. There is empty cells, but if you look, there is no single cell where is multiple entry of rules. Each cell where is the entry, it is only single production rule is entered. Okay, so if some grammar is LL1 grammar, then its parse table will have only maximum one entry per cell. Okay, maximum one entry, minimum zero. Okay, is LL1 grammar. Okay, so one input symbol used as look ahead symbol to determine parser action in LL1 leftmost derivation. So, if you see here, when we are going to drive this derivation tree, how will take them, take a decision? We will see that, okay, so if we are starting from the root, say we will start with E definitely, then whatever string has been given to you, okay, you have to find out that string is starting with what. If it is starting with ID, then we are going to search for match of E to ID, okay, match E to ID, and that is having a entry here, so we will go with that entry, E. Sorry.